Things always occur in combination and look very different from each other and feel quite different. Nevertheless, the feeling of difference between them allows each one to exist. And so underneath the opposition or the polarity between self and other or between any other pair of opposites you can think of, there is something in common, as there is, for example, between figure and background. You can't see a figure without a background. You can't have an organism without an environment. Equally, you can't have a background without a figure, or an environment without organisms in it, or without things in it. You can't have space, which is unoccupied by any solid. You cannot have solids not occupying some space. This is absolutely elementary. And yet, we don't realize it. Because, for example, the average person thinks that space is nothing. But it's just a sort of not-there-ness in which there are things. And we are slightly afraid that not-there-ness, that nothingness, that darkness, that the negative poles of all these oppositions will win. That they will eventually swallow up every kind of being and every kind of there-ness. But when you catch on to the game, you realize that that won't happen. Because what is called not existing is quite incapable of being there without the contrast of something called existing. It's like the crest and the trough of a wave. You can't have a wave that is all trough and no crest, just as you can't have a wave which is all crest and no trough. Such a thing has never been manifested in the physical universe. They go together. And that is the secret.